Hey, what's up, y'all? So it's been a minute since y'all really kicked it with me. We did some DIY stuff. It's been a minute, but I'm back on it. I'm ready to make some more content. So YouTube, Instagram, watch out. I'm coming. Y'all rock with me as I tie-dye some synthetic fabric. Let's go. So I had this dope idea for some custom blazers. I got some low white custom blazers, my size, for like 30 bucks less at the Nike outlet store. Actually, not even the outlet store, it's just the downtown Detroit store. So I was like, I got some ideas, I got some paint, I'm still trying to show off, trying to do some different things. So amongst that though, of course, I wanted to put this faux fur on it, right? Like, it's winter time, is the colors are very Thanksgiving, fall, winter type season. So I wanted to do this fur, except it's not the right color. So I tried one method of just like painting with acrylic paint, y'all. That was a mess. Like, for real, that was a mess. So I finally found, you know, I went to my Googles, like smart people do. I found some different methods that make way more sense. I know some different things now, so I'm ready to teach y'all. Let's go.
In order for me to do this, I need, of course, materials, right? So the first thing I have is this RIT dye more synthetic. And this is especially important because this is the color that I want this here to become, right? This is gonna be perfect for the blazers that I'm working on. All right, next, we also have this Colorstay because I don't want it to bleed. I don't want it to wear off. Like, I want it to stay. That's really why I'm trying different things for this, because I wanna make customs that stay. All right, so we're gonna do this after the fact. Of course, we got some gloves because I usually love getting paint, but I have heard this is not fun to get on your hands, so I'm gonna listen. All right, got some tongs because we're gonna be moving around. Of course, we got the cuts that I need for these kicks. All right, some random white socks. I have this pair of white socks I've been sitting on, needing to tie dye and play around with. So I'm gonna color these too, because why not? And they might go with the kicks. And we have this pot. Now, this pot, we stopped cooking in this a while ago. Probably need to buy a new one now. But yeah, I'm gonna use this pot. You have to use the stovetop method in order to do synthetic fibers. I'll get into that soon. And then, last but not least, this dish detergent. It's not just here because we're in the kitchen. It's here because we need it for this. And yeah, we need this too. This is from me hydro dipping. I'm gonna need new buckets soon. But we're gonna do this, we're gonna use it for the last stage. All right, let's keep going.
All right, y'all, so first things first, we gotta get this pot full, and we need it boiling too. Like, you have to do this for the synthetic. Now, I am gonna make another video, so pay attention to the YouTube, pay attention to my Instagram. I'm gonna make another video just doing a regular dye. But for the synthetic, you have to use the stove method. Don't forget that. I'm telling you, don't forget that. All right, so it's time to get some water in this pot. Let's get it moving, and let's get some stuff dying. All right, so I got this pot full of water. Y'all didn't wanna watch that. Now I have it over here in my stove. I'm gonna get this cranking now, and let's get this water. We're supposed to get it to 200 degrees and above, so we're gonna get it to a nice, good simmer. So I'm thinking medium, because we also have to keep it there. All right, let's go ahead. There we go. All right, the five. All right, so that's doing that thing. Let me go grab the things real quick. I got the socks I wanna do. I got the pieces of fur I wanna do. This is gonna be pretty dope. I'm excited, y'all. Like, I'm excited. Tongs, gloves. All right, so we can do all of this, of course, while the water is going. That's pretty cool. So, word to the wise, put a top on. All right, the water is finally where we want it to be. It took forever. Word to the wise, I don't actually know. It just took forever, so I guess word to the wise, just be patient. But it definitely is where we want it to be now. So we'll check the temp. That little thermometer is slightly broken at the moment, and it's also giving me Celsius, which is rude. But I did check that 200 degrees or more is in the 93.9 range of Celsius, so we're looking good.
So I'm going to go ahead and add the teaspoon. Turn off. Why are you so broke? All right, cool. So we'll go ahead and add the teaspoon of dish detergent. All right. This is to help everything even out. All right, so I'm going to do that. All right. Did put some plastic down over here just in case I have to stir something or whatever. The tongs are going to be wet. You know, I don't want this to stain the countertops. All right. Don't need hubs mad at me. All right. So now going to add in this. Let's read those directions one more time. Teaspoon, yep, add dye. Then we're going to do that. Then we're going to do this for 30 minutes, y'all. All right. So we're gonna let this sit. I'm gonna put the furs in, put the socks in. So y'all are gonna watch me. It's doing its thing, it's bubbling. It says to do half a bottle for 3 gallons. I don't think we have 3 gallons. Of course, gloves, you know? So get one more good shake in. All right, so I'm gonna do maybe a third of the bottle. All right, so. For later for another project. Let's get that mixed in well. All right, using these tongs, which are now my fashion tongs. Again, nothing I gotta go to Amazon and replace now. It is what it is. I'm gonna put this over there in my pot. All right, this brown is looking good. That's looking good. All right, I'm gonna add a little bit more just because we want to be really sure about this color. I'll be real with y'all. First go around, I'll probably, you know, play around with this a little bit as I go along. It's gonna be easier when we do the not synthetic, because, well, we won't be, we'll be using that in a tub. You don't have to do stovetop for not synthetic, but synthetic requires some heat to that. All right, this definitely looks like, see, words of the wise, be careful. I'm pretty sure I just got brown dot on the shirt. Oh, well. This is why I finally stopped wearing dope shit while doing this. All right, so that's good. So now I am going to literally put the fabric pieces I want in. I'm going to make sure they are fully submerged. It's already doing some things. All right, so as it's doing that, get those submerged in there. And then of course, like I said, do a pair of socks. Now these are actually cotton. I didn't have to do synthetic, so I'm kind of curious how these are going to turn out anyway. So I'm going to do that. We are going to mix in there. I'm going to turn the water down so it doesn't get too crazy. So we don't want it to boil. We do want it hot though. All right, not at boiling point, but we do want it hot. So get that. Everything is in there. Get y'all a close up of that. Ew, is that? Oh. Alright, so let's get y'all in here. Okay, welcome as we move. Let's see if I can. Nope, as we move, there we go. So, got the stuff in there. It is simmering, it is brewing. Will not get the camera too close. Don't need no fog, but yeah. So, okay, Google, set a timer for 30 minutes. And now we wait.
For 30 minutes, starting now.
Now, just a couple of quick notes while I'm waiting those 30 minutes. Y'all saw me put on a timer, so make sure you do that, because I'll be moving around. I'll forget, y'all may forget, do the timer. 2, you do have to constantly stir, so you can't put the lid back on, which is fine. You don't want it to get too hot. And also, make sure you constantly stir during those 30 minutes, all right? I'm gonna probably come over every few minutes, you know, give it a couple whirls, continue about my life or whatever, and wait till that timer gets off. So grab yourself something to drink while we wait, stir, come back, grab a snack, stir. We got 30 minutes, do what you do. So my timer went off. I'm gonna go ahead and shut this off. All right, definitely looking at some very brown pieces. That's the color I was looking for, a chocolate brown. Dark brown was out, and chocolate brown's definitely gonna go with this color scheme, I think the best. This definitely looks like it got dyed, right? So now what I'm going to do is, I've had this turned off now. So now what I need to do is add that dry fixate that you guys saw. It's a, not dry fixate, sorry, dye fixate. Figured that might be a little bit better. So now I'm gonna add this dye fixate that you guys saw Definitely great for synthetics. I'm gonna put it right over there. So this is turned off. I'm gonna get that tub ready. Y'all saw that tub earlier. And y'all are just gonna rock with me. All right, let's do a little box. Hey, how y'all doing? All right, so now remember, I have this tub, right? And what I'm now gonna do is I'm gonna leave that in the dye for now. I'm gonna fill up this tub with super hot water. My suggestion to you may be to boil it. You know your water best, or your sink or your pipes or whatever. My kitchen water gets scorching. It gets absolutely scorching. So I'm gonna get it hot. I'm gonna then put, you know, fill this tub up. I'm going to put the dye fixate in, mix that up a little bit. Then I'm gonna get those pieces out of that water and put them in here, stir this up. Now this has to sit for 20 minutes. Yes, this is a not quick, but not super long process. It just takes time. So remember that I told you one of those things you needed with that was patience. This is patience, all right? We don't have too much left to do though, but I wanna go ahead and get that going. I'm gonna let my water run for a second. So I see some smoke coming up, then I'm gonna put that in, then we're gonna do the thing, all right? All right, so we got the smoke, we got this super hot water in the tub. Wait, make sure y'all get some of that. Y'all see that? All right, so now I'm gonna go get the tub of stuff. We're gonna do what I said earlier, right?
So sink.
Just in case anything splashes off, it's in the sink, all right? I'm now going to go back. Grab those tongs I now have to replace. I'm just gonna go to Family Dollar. That's it. That's all I'm gonna do. All right, and then, oh, before we even do that, I'm tripping. Gotta add this in, right? So I'm gonna do, let's see. For this one, I'm gonna do about half of the bottle. All right, so I'm gonna shake this up well. Got the water going. So I'm gonna put half of this in there. All right, so a little bit more. All right, that's good. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna stir this up. Have it do its thing. All right, stir that up. And now, I'm gonna use these tongs and go get our pieces. So remember, okay Google, set a timer for 20 minutes.
Second timer for 20 minutes.
Cool.
Starting now.
And we're gonna let this do its thing for a little bit. And then we're gonna wrap up at the end. All right, so of course, gonna get that last stir in. All right. It's looking really good, y'all. It's looking really good. So now I need to take this downstairs. I need to kind of rinse this out with cool water. So I'm gonna rinse them out with cool water. Then I'm gonna throw them in the washer. And we're gonna get to washing them, so let's go downstairs. Welcome to the basement.
Let me get one more light, y'all.
It is indeed a little dark and a little spooky down here. Y'all hear that? Anyways, this is where our laundry room is. I'm gonna tie my hair back, which I probably should do in the beginning. I don't know. Sorry. I like my hair down. So I'm gonna tie it back now, and now I'm definitely going to go upstairs and get my gloves. All right, so gloves are back on, because we're going to dump this water out, and then we are going to rinse out each piece. I'm gonna put it directly in the washing machine right here below me, and then we're gonna clean them a little bit, and then they should be good to go after we dry them. So let's come down with me. All right, so yes, utility sink is dirty. That's what it's for. So we are going to just slowly pull this down and drain this out. All right, so now I got all these pieces. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna get some cold water going. I'm gonna rinse them all out, make sure that they run, the water runs clear, basically. All right, so literally grab a piece. Let's see what we got here. All right, so y'all remember what this looked like, right? So we're gonna, it's nice. I'm digging this, y'all. Now, I'm gonna put these in the wash machine. Supposed to do it with warm water. Gonna do like a low tumble, gentle with it. And we're gonna get these officially done. They look pretty good, y'all. I'm really excited. Of course, y'all know I'm coming back with the finished. All right, y'all. So we are now officially done. Like, I'm finished, and I want to show y'all how this came out. So remember, I had two different things I did in synthetic. One was the socks. Now the socks, they actually didn't need a synthetic, but I wanted to try it since I was already doing some other things in that. This is how they came out. Pretty cool. I mean, clearly I'm going to wear them. I don't have socks this color. Cool. So the fur, right? Remember, the fur looked like this before we went, right? Before we started this process, the fur looked like this. Told y'all, didn't like this color for the sneaker, the colorway that I'm doing right now. I needed more brown. That's why we did this. Pretty good. Not bad. It actually looks like almost better after it's been like thoroughly washed in this whole process. Like, it actually looks better. I'm excited to put this on the sneaker. The pieces are so small. I lost a piece, so I gotta go find that. But this is what that did. Thank y'all for rocking with me. Make sure you follow my Instagram. Make sure you follow my YouTube channel. Out.